Praise God. Welcome to Jumpstart for Jesus. God is good. Hallelujah. In the Old Testament, we see many people walked with God and they were blessed. Hallelujah. We see Enoch walked with God and he was taken up to heaven alive. Abraham was called to walk with God and he was blessed in every area of his life. Noah walked with God and he and his family was saved from the great flood. Hallelujah. Praise God. There is blessing in walking with God. There is protection in walking with God. Hallelujah. So friend, today God is calling you to walk with him. Hallelujah. As you walk with the Lord, you shall be blessed in every area of your life. You shall have protection from all sides. You will be protected in every area of your life. And Lord Jesus is coming very soon to take us up to heaven alive. Hallelujah. Praise God. So friend, how did these people, this man of God, walked with God? Walking is a continuous movement of steps in a particular direction. If you fall down and you stop there, it means you are not walking. If you fall sick, if you are hurt and if you stop there, it means you are not walking. So walking is a continuous movement, continuous progress. It is a continuous walking with God. Hallelujah. Praise God. I remember someone once told me, life is not about how many times you fall down, but how many times you rise up and keep walking until you reach the finish line. Hallelujah. Praise God. So friend, in those times, in the times of Enoch, Abraham and Noah, there was no Holy Spirit in them. They had to wait for God to reply to their questions. They had to wait for God to speak to them. Hallelujah. Yet they managed to walk with God. Today, let's see how they managed to walk with God in those times and learn from them how we can walk with God in our life. Hallelujah. If you want to walk with God, there are three things we must know about our God. Hallelujah. The first thing that we must know is that there is a God. You must believe that there is a God and the God wants to bless you. The God wants to walk with you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hebrews 11 verse 6 tells us, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Hallelujah. So the first thing that we must believe is that there is a God, and the God wants to bless you. The God wants to make you prosper. God wants to see you victorious. You see you in good health. Hallelujah. If you believe that there is a God, then you can walk with him. Hallelujah. You cannot come near God and say, I don't know whether God loves me or not. I don't know whether God knows me or not. Hallelujah. Bible tells us he knows you even before you were conceived in your mother's womb. Hallelujah. He has loved you with an everlasting love. Hallelujah. Praise God. So first thing we must know is we must believe that there is a God and that he wants to walk with us. Hallelujah. The second what we must know about God is God is talking to us continuously, regardless of we hearing him or not. Hallelujah. So God has been talking to mankind since creation. When he created Adam and Eve, he was talking to them in the Garden of Eden. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 tells us, God who at various times in various ways spoke in the time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son. Hallelujah. So Bible tells us God has been talking to us from all times. God has been talking to mankind since creation. So if you want to walk with God, you must believe that there is a God. You must believe that God is talking to mankind continuously. God is talking to you right now at this moment as you watch this video. God has been talking to mankind. It is his desire that he wants to talk to you. John 16 verse 13 tells us, how be it when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. Hallelujah. Praise God. So in the time of Enoch, Noah, Abraham, they did not have the Holy Spirit dwelling in them to speak to them. But today, if you believe in Jesus Christ, you are blessed with the Spirit of God. You have the Holy Spirit dwelling in you, who is talking to you continuously, who is guiding, giving instructions to you continuously. Hallelujah. And the third thing that we must know about God is God wants us to know him and know his will. Hallelujah. So God wants us to know him and know his will for our life, his plans for our life, his desires for our life. John 17:3 tells us, and this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Hallelujah. Praise God. So only if you know the God, you can walk with that God. Only if you know his desires, his plans, and his thoughts for your life, then you can walk with the God. So when you come before God, you must know that there is a God who blesses. There is a God who wants to make you prosper. When you come before God, you must believe that he is talking to you right now, all the time, every time, wherever you are, in whatever situation you are, God is talking to you continuously. Hallelujah. And the third thing, you must know your God. When you know your God, you can walk with your God. When you know his plans for your life, you can walk and focus your life on his plans to walk with him. Hallelujah. Hebrew 8 verse 9 tells us, for this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law, that is instructions, wills, plans, and desires of God, in their mind, and write them on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Hallelujah. Praise God. What a wonderful God we serve. God says, in the new covenant relationship with through Jesus Christ, I will have my instructions, my plans, my desires written on their minds. I will write them on their hearts, and they will know everything that I desire. They will know everything that I want. They will know all my plans for their life. Hallelujah. This is the God we serve, and he has given us the Holy Spirit to dwell in us, to guide us according to the will of the Father, to guide us according to the plans of the Father God. Hallelujah. So these are the three things which we must know about our God if you want to walk with God. Hallelujah. But there are some things that we can learn from those who walked with God. We can learn from the prophets who have walked with God. So friend, today we saw how we can walk with God, knowing three things about God. In my next video, which will be a continuation of this video, we will learn from the prophets who have walked with God, how they walked with God, and together learning from them, we can walk with God. Hallelujah. So stay tuned for my next video. God bless you. God. Do subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell for notifications and share the link with your friends and family, and they will be blessed. God bless you.